Struggling with heavy oil overflow or plastic production bottlenecks in Factorio? Are you manually flushing fluids in your pipelines or adding an obscene amount of tanks to temporarily prevent fluid clogging? That was me back in the day too. But these problems can be corrected with fluid cracking and circuit conditions to cleanly balance fluid outputs, and I will show you how. Let me demonstrate with an example of a simple cracking build where we'll break down one fluid product into another. First, I've unlocked advanced oil processing in the Factorio tech tree. To optimize product throughput, I do want to make sure I use the correct ratios of chemical plants and refineries. So I input my desired product or cents per minute into the Kirk McDonald calculator, like you can see here. In this example, I'm aiming to produce 120 yellow cents per minute without the use of any beacons or modules. Per the calculator, we need 7.2 oil refineries to make heavy oil, then 1.7 chemical plants for cracking heavy oil into light oil, and 5.9 chemical plants to crack light oil into petroleum. We will of course round up the use of chemical plants for the respective fluids since there is no fraction of a chemical plant and to prevent underproduction. With the number of chemical plants and refineries now known, we can build our balanced chemical plants with these steps. Step 1, we're going to place down the refineries and chemical plants based off the ratios outlined in the calculator. We're going to set up pipe outputs for the three fluids to go into one tank each of petroleum, light oil, and heavy oil. Step 2, we are going to configure pipe inputs and outputs into at least one tank, cracking heavy into light oil, then we'll configure the chemical plants and pipes for light oil into petroleum. Step 3, measure fluid contents. Now I'm wiring my tanks to measure their contents. I do this by holding down the wire button and clicking each fluid tank, then connecting to a shared power pole nearby. Hovering over the power pole, you'll be able to see the measured fluid in each tank. It does not matter if either green or red wire is used, but be sure to use the same colored wire for all steps. Step 4. Use wires to connect pumps and tanks. Next is to add pumps for fluid going away from the tanks into the cracking chemical plants. These pumps will be used to turn on or off the fluid going into these chemical plants, which is key to fluid balancing. Then more wire is added from the shared power pole to these pumps. Step 5. Enable pumps with circuit conditions. Now set the pump conditions. Make sure the Enable/Disable box is clicked. The pump leading from the heavy oil tank into light oil cracking will only be enabled if light oil is less than heavy oil. The pump leading from the light oil tank into petroleum cracking will only be enabled if petroleum is less than light oil. If you plan on attaching lubricant production to this build, now is the time to add at least one lubricant chemical plant and tank with wire for measurement. Add an additional pump from the heavy oil tank outputting into the lubricant chemical plant. In this case, we will only enable disable if lubricant is less than heavy oil. If we want to add sulfuric acid measuring, we'll add in a sulfuric acid build, add a tank for sulfuric acid measuring. Additionally, wire up the sulfuric acid contents to the rest of the shared wires, then wire an additional pump from the petroleum output into the sulfuric acid build. The conditions on this pump will be to only enable disable if sulfuric acid is less than petroleum. It's possible to complicate this build further by continuing to measure fluid outputs and compare to other fluids or even items on belts if each respective item is connected to the circuit network with conditions enabled. Combinators can also be used in place of or in addition to these steps, but this setup is still the simplest way to prevent fluid clogging while maintaining fluid throughput. Of course, you can play Factorio without ever going through all this trouble, but without any conditions on these fluid outputs, it's possible to end up with too much of one fluid and not enough of the other, which will directly affect the balance or throughput of products that rely on these ingredients, which makes cracking ratios and circuit conditions so important, especially when having a specific product per minute goal in mind. You can of course also rely solely on basic oil processing in place of advanced oil processing for petroleum production like I have in certain situations, but advanced oil processing produces more petroleum for the same amount of crude oil input, which is 55 versus 45, which means advanced oil processing is more bang for your buck. Another thing to keep in mind when building a fluid cracking setup is whether you value scalability or a more compact build. If you are considering increasing your items per minute in the future, opt for builds that can be expanded upon easily and give yourself plenty of room. On the other hand, having a compact blueprint ready to go for commonly used ratios is especially useful in the early game. So that sums up the simplest way to balance fluids via the circuit network. If you liked this tutorial, want any of the blueprint examples, or want to leave any suggestions on future tutorials you would like to see, please let me know, and I will plan on seeing you next time. Thank you. And I'll